to the old business of repurposing, to the city hall.
Do you have anybody who signed up under open forum and did put a list up there? No.
I have a list right here.
I have an official printout for people to sign up and speak. Yes. Were you wanting to speak, anyone? No. Okay.
I'll probably make just a quick comment, but I may have questions or something.
It would only be under open forum.
Yeah, this
we're
is the
going
place.
To have.
This is the time.
Only under open forum.
Yeah.
So we can't participate in the meeting at all,
no.
As we've done in the past.
No.
No.
Is there a reason for that?
That I'm not sure that we were handling that appropriately in the past.
Yeah, it's no different than council rules. Did you want to, do you have a question or?
Just want to listen.
Okay. All righty. Okay, so it leads us to the memorandum then for, and then our recommendations that we're going to send to City Council for the Tuesday meeting. I think everybody got a copy. It was in the packet.
Mm-hmm. No, that's not in the packet.
Oh, okay.
Would you like me to make a copy for you?
No, I'll get it here. When did you send it?
Yesterday.
Bear with me for just a moment.
Corey, just use this one. It'd take me 2 seconds to print one out.
Here, you can have mine if you just come.
No, I don't want to take a second. Okay. Sorry about that. I'm assuming all this historical information is correct.
It is. It's pretty detailed, actually, in terms of the history of the building itself. So,
mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So the purpose of this meeting was really to have a working meeting to work on this memorandum to go to City Council based on the recommendation that we made at the last meeting regarding that City Council set public hearings to get input from the community to consider a 2, 2.5, or 4-story option for a mixed-use development, including a new City Hall. We did go through and included information in here regarding background, which Dave Kennedy provided much of that information. And then I tried to include information on here regarding an analysis and fiscal impact based on what Mr. Kangeis provided at our last meeting. The recommendation, as it is worded in this memo, was based on the recommendation that we made at the last meeting. I think if there are any amendments we want to make to that recommendation prior to this going to City Council, this working session would be part of where we make that change along with any other information we want to add or modify in this memo.
So does the recommendation just fall out as a recommendation, or do we put anything as to what the CIC will do with what comes back from council? Is that premature to put that in?
I do not know the answer to that.
It's just so a recommendation is basically the City Council set public hearings. Does the recommendation have to have anything of what we'll do to follow up after those public hearings, or is that not?
Well, I also think too, and Dave, correct me if I'm wrong, we have to set the public hearings to get the public input on it. But also, do we also, because aren't there some statutory requirements too in terms of?
Yeah, City Council would and could, when they do the public hearing, could also put the, anytime you're selling, disposing, transferring
right.
property, there needs to be a public hearing on that.
Okay.
So, but that would be a council action.
So we could do both though, as part of this recommendation?
That would require a council member, yeah, when they do the actions, to add that to it.
At the council meeting.
I'm not sure, since the city currently owns the property,
right.
I don't believe that should be part of our recommendation.
Okay,
but
that's where I was getting, because I'm going back to Carl's question, because I think what eventually will happen is when City Council does do that transfer, then it comes back
okay.
to us. Is
that
right?
I believe
so. When they do the public hearing somebody from council would make the, would say, you would make the recommendation that
to also set the public
notice for the public hearing includes the statutory, that the public should get an option on the sale or disposal or transfer.
Okay. Thank you.
But Kelly's right, since that's a city-owned, it should come from council.
Okay.
And I don't, I'm not gonna repeat since I stepped out, but we really did try to spend some time on the history. And actually found the, put that history book about the city. That's how I got some of the dates, and Mark got quite a bit of history, and so that was the buildup. And I felt that it was prudent to explain in a little bit of detail, okay, when we looked at Safety Center, we looked at the northern addition, we looked at the rear addition, and we secured property on the northern side. And then I thought it was also worthwhile to explain, to clearly put out there that at one point in time we did consider looking at the Moose Building. Mark and I went through it, we looked at it as a rehab, a full gut, or a level, and a brand new one. And so that was another option. And then when we talk about Public Works, we're only telling you that Public Works was part of the review, but at that time it was only to sort of why we had them, have them sort of stake out the future needs of that particular property. We never really looked at moving City Hall down there. So when they talk about Public Works, it is a sort of separate item, but we felt it should be referenced.
Yeah, I think the history on it's great, and I think it's interesting too, because we also had, we had mentioned at the last meeting too, that there was actually a study done on the building back in 1997 with the facilities task force or whatever. And their recommendation, basically, they said it had about a 10-year lifespan, that it would have to either be completely, you know, either completely redone or, you know, torn down and replaced. And that was in 97, so that would have been 10-year lifespan. We put it at 2007, and here we are at 2017. So I think that was also helpful to put in there as well, so that people could see this has not been, this is not something that just came up in the last year or two. This is something that, quite frankly, has always been the intention, I think, that this was never really going to be the permanent structure. So.
And I always think it's important to note that when the whole process began, as far as looking for an alternative location for City Hall, the plan in the very beginning never included us being down here. I will say, I always envisioned that we would be at the Safety Center, this way, that way, this way, that way. It wasn't until we started to realize that there was some real sentiment of the city being downtown that the whole focus sort of changed back to. And what backed that up was the fact that both of the northern and the rear option at the Safety Center just were not feasible. They were extremely expensive, required us securing other lands, and it just wasn't going to work. That sort of circled us back. When this whole thing started, I thought, well, I'm going to be working on Safety Center. We never envisioned.